Let's get ready to rumble!
I think that's the first opening kickoff that Michael Buffer's ever called. Into the end zone. By the way, the 49ers won the toss. They defer. Rams get the ball. Spanish language broadcast available today on Fox Deportes. And off we go. A year ago today that Aaron was talking about, Matthew Stafford went to Cabo. A Lion came back a Ram, and they got him for a game like this.
They sure did. Not just to get to this game, but to move on and ultimately win a Super Bowl.
Quick throw, back him out on the edge. And forced out of bounds by Ambry Thomas, the rookie, after a gain of three. Matthew Stafford, his best year statistically, 41 touchdowns, second most in the NFL. And you see what he's done this postseason, it's been off the charts. Pass is caught, short of first down yardage by Van Jefferson. Gain of four, so third and short coming up.
Well, the way Matthew Stafford finished up the regular season, it wasn't exactly on a high note. Of course, they lost Week 18 when they had an opportunity to knock San Francisco out and not let them in the postseason. But boy, has he played well, like you said, Joe. The wild card round against Arizona last week and that win on the road against Tampa Bay. He is playing as well as he has all year.
Surveys, finds Beckham, and he can't make the catch as the throw was behind him. It's three and out for the Rams. Beckham wide open, and Stafford threw it behind him.
He sure was. He started to his left. He was working the left side, and he came back and just got erratic with the throw. Pretty good release there by Odell Beckham, but the ball behind him and not able to make that catch. We've certainly seen Beckham make tons of those plays, but a tough catch here in the early going to try.
Back at a punt, Travis Benjamin waits. Good punt. Benjamin back inside the 15. Out of bounds near the 20. 58-yard punt by Johnny Hecker and a 9-yard return. And here comes Jimmy Garoppolo. And you can talk about the statistics all you want. And the interceptions or the ill-timed throws, whatever you want. But he is 4-1 in the postseason and 6-0 in his career as a 49er against the Rams.
That's all anybody cares about. He doesn't care about the stats, nor do his teammates. And all week we've heard about how resilient he is. We've seen it throughout his career since he arrived in San Francisco. But his teammates, most importantly, believe in him that when he needs to make the plays, he will make them.
Debo in the backfield next to Garoppolo, and they hand it to him, and he gets nothing. Back to the line of scrimmage, and A'shaun Robinson there for LA. No gain.
There's no secret what they want to do. Here's A'shaun Robinson, number 94. He sheds the block by George Kittle and fills the hole. They're going to get a heavy dose of Elijah Mitchell, and they're going to get a lot of Debo Samuel. And how well can they hold up?
Samuel again in the backfield now with Juszczyk. Toss. Juszczyk with a block. And a short gain of three. This offense for San Francisco, just two offensive touchdowns total through two games. But they've found a way to win. And there's their offensive line with a Pro Bowler and one of the better athletes on the team, Trent Williams, at left tackle, playing with a sprained ankle.
Yeah, and a bit of a question mark, Joe, as far as, you know, will he be able to go the distance? There may be times, like we saw last week in Green Bay, that he may have to come out if he re-aggravates that ankle. But I know they're sure happy to have him. He's been outstanding all year long.
Third down and seven over the middle. Kittle overthrown. And this time Garoppolo had a receiver wide open for a first down and maybe even more, and he missed him.
Boy, sure did. Kittle gets a free release off the line. He is wide open. Nick Scott is the only guy who has a chance to try to come back on this and then make a play after the catch. And just one that gets away. So here in the early going, we've already seen a little nerves here. For a quarterback, it happens. In the NFC Championship game, we saw Stafford miss a third down, and now Garoppolo missed his.
Wisnowski hits it end over end, and it's hauled in by Brandon Powell with a fair catch. 44-yard punt. Second possession for the Rams just underway in the champ game. And the players that went 12-5 during the regular season, number four seed in the playoff picture on the NFC side, and Sean McVay in his fifth year, a Kyle Shanahan disciple. He's lost six straight to his buddy across the way. First down, Rams did not run the ball first time they had it on that three and out. But they do here. Run it with Akers. And he's across the 35, got three. Look at this offense and where they stack up. Ninth overall, and Andrew Whitworth at left tackle. He's back. Missed the game at Tampa Bay and was 11 years a Cincinnati Bengal, and his old team is going to Super Bowl 56.
How about that? Congratulations to Cincinnati on their big win at Kansas City, and a good thing that Andrew Whitworth is able to go today. Joe Noteboom, who filled in for him last week in Tampa, who played an excellent ball game, he's inactive for this one.
Stafford in trouble and has to throw it away in the direction of Higby, and was under pressure by Dre Greenlaw. Brings up third and seven.
Well, the 49ers don't bring a lot right here. They don't bring pressure all that often, but they decide to bring the linebacker. He shoots the gap, gets right into Stafford's face. He just has to unload it.
First down of the game, and who else? Cooper Kupp. 17 yards on third and seven.
Well, you give Matthew Stafford time against this zone coverage, you're going to see Cooper Kupp, how effective he is running routes when he's got space in between those defenders. He doesn't tip anything off when he runs routes. He's as good as anybody in the league. It's why he led the league in receptions and yards and everything else. He is a total technician off the line of scrimmage.
Stafford protected, finds Akers, and he gets dumped immediately by Kaywan Williams. This defense makes me think of the old Mike Tyson line. Great line. Everybody has a plan until they get hit in the mouth. And this San Francisco team, top to bottom, defense, offense, they'll hit you in the mouth.
Well, they've been hitting people in the mouth ever since the midway point of the season. That's when they moved number 91 right there in the middle of your screen to the inside. And he has been wreaking havoc. He's playing some of his best football. A lot of these guys, Fred Warner included, Jaquaski Tart, are just playing really good ball at just the right time.
Second and eight. Stafford keeps, throws, Higby. First down inside the 35. Higby's a sneaky target for Matthew Stafford. Doesn't get the headlines, but man, he has really blossomed.
He has been a real complimentary player. Had a big game week 18 against these 49ers. He's played well the last couple of weeks. He makes the catches. He does all the dirty work. I like what the Rams are doing in the passing game. They're getting it out of Stafford's hands pretty quickly,
including here to Beckham. And Odell Beckham Jr. got about 10.
Odell Beckham at the end of the season, I mean, he's really come along. Of course, it was when they first met back in the middle of the year. It was his first week after Robert Woods went down, and he's been getting acclimated to this offense, and he's gotten better and better. But at the end of the season, wasn't getting the big plays. He's gotten those in the first two playoff games. Some of that run after the catch, but he obviously is a real weapon. Opposite of Cooper Kupp.
Eight passes, one run so far for the Rams.
Hey, righty, righty.
Run number two, and it's Akers again, and he's got some room down inside the 10.
Well, Austin Corbett and Rob Havenstein, right guard, right tackle, they collapse the three technique right there. And as soon as you get that kind of movement, and you see Skoranek, number 18, he cleans it up as well. But when you get that kind of movement on that interior defensive tackle, you're going to pick up some big gains like we just saw.
Akers, who missed basically the entire year, came back for week 18, tore his Achilles in July. And somehow, here he is. Fourth game back, gets it here. Bottled up, spins out, maybe back to the line of scrimmage. Second and goal.
Well, of course, last week against Tampa Bay, they had that big lead, and then Akers put the ball on the ground a couple of times in that game that allowed Tampa Bay to come back, and he hasn't been really a fumbler. Last year on 190 carries, he just put the ball on the ground one time, but in visiting with Sean McVay, they do want to work Sony Michel into this game more. He was not used much at all last week.
Stafford, Higbee, popped and dropped at the three. And a combo tackle between Mosley and Tart. Third and goal.
It's a really good job as Mosley comes up. He comes off of his guy on the outside, and they squeeze Higbee after he's able to catch it.
Sony Michel checks into the huddle for the first time in the game.
They could certainly hand the ball off to Sony Michel, but he's the better pass protector, so we're going to see him probably in some of those situations. It lends me to believe this is a pass.
Tenth play of the drive. Stafford, end zone, pass in the air, and picked by Ward. And on the return, Jimmy Ward outside the 20 as K'Wan Williams made that play in the end zone. It was a pass, and it is an interception.
K'Wan Williams is in such great coverage here on Cup, a ball that's a little behind, and that causes a deflection.
Jimmy Ward took it back the other way, and the 49ers have it, still no score. Welcome back to the NFC Championship game presented by Intuit TurboTax Live at SoFi Stadium. Aerial coverage today provided by Tubi. First postseason interception is a Ram by Matthew Stafford. Fifth all-in that he's thrown this season to the 49ers. Here's a completion, and that's Ayuk for a first down. We saw Stafford upset going to break, and here's why. After the interception, he gets hit, Mike Pereira, in the back of the head by Fred Warner.
Yeah, and it is a foul. He gets protection after the interception. Any contact to the head or shoulder area is a foul, and he's even out of the play at this point, so it should have been called.
It's unusual not to see that called. Carl Cheffers, the referee, they typically are watching for that protection on the quarterback.
And just to finish on the interception is Elijah Mitchell, carries for three. Jimmy Ward had two first quarter interceptions against Stafford in week 10. And, you know, a guy who was a converted corner, he settled in at safety, and Matthew Stafford, who tied for the league lead in interceptions, hadn't thrown one this postseason until that play on third and goal. Second and seven. Garoppolo underneath, that's Mitchell. And Elijah Mitchell with a nice catch and run into Rams territory for 18 yards.
Well, this is a great job by this San Francisco offensive line. The protection and the time that they afford Garoppolo in the pocket. He's able to sit back there. They double Brandon Ayuk on the inside as he's going up the field. And Garoppolo with good decision making is patient. Comes down to Elijah Mitchell, and they pick up the first down.
Nice little stiff arm from Elijah Mitchell into Troy Reader for extra yards. Toss to Mitchell. And the young man from Louisiana grew up in Erath, Louisiana, and he set the 49ers rookie record with his 963 rushing yards this season, gets one. Second and nine. Great production out of a sixth-round pick for that man, Kyle Shanahan, and Elijah Mitchell, the 11th running back taken in this past draft. Here he is with Juszczyk in front of him, and he drives to the 40. Aaron Donald makes that stop. You still have time to stack the cash and win even more of Terry's money. The more people who enter Fox Super 6's NFC Championship Contest, the bigger the jackpot gets. Scan the QR code now and play for free.
Well, these are big downs right here on third down, and that's an area where the Rams really struggled defensively in those two regular season matchups against San Francisco. They just had a hard time getting off the field, and that allowed San Francisco to control the time of possession, continue to run the football, so winning on this down is important.
Garoppolo backpedals and throws incomplete for Ayuk. Covered by Darius Williams and Troy Reader. It's fourth down.
Well, Troy Reader is on the inside, and these are some of the throws that Garoppolo, he got away with them last week, and sometimes he doesn't see quite what's out in front of him. And when you get pressure in his face, there goes Reader right there, and he had a chance to undercut that ball and make a play on it. The 49ers pretty happy that that hit the ground and incomplete.
Pass on a 58-yard field goal try, which would tie a career long for Robbie Gould. And Wisnowski tries to pin the Rams deep. And well played.
Oh.
Trent Sherfield is the one who kept it out of the end zone, and Ross Dwelly downs it. Special teams make the case. Special teams won the game in Green Bay and off to a good start here in California. No score. Well, Jalen Ramsey was a little shaken up on that special teams play. We'll show you how and why if we get a chance here as the Rams start at their own three after the good special teams play by the 49ers. A unit that's been under fire all year. A big game in Green Bay and a nice start here. Here's Trenton Cannon, 49, who was just activated for this game. And he grabbed the face mask of Jalen Ramsey and kind of dragged him down to the turf. Second and 10 for the Rams.
Yeah, he got a hold of him pretty good. Right now, you look at this and the way that it's gone. I know Sean McVay, yeah, there's Tyler Higbee, talking about how much that he's able to do. He's hobbling off. That's not looking good for the Rams.
Well, they start this game, the Rams, with Bryson Hopkins inactive. They're only down to Kendall Blanton.
Kendall Blanton had his first career touchdown reception versus Tampa.
Here's a carry by Michelle, and he fights his way out across the 10. Got a good block from Kendall Blanton.
Yeah, well, that's a good sign there, that if they're able to get this running game going a little bit, they've been so heavy in passing because San Francisco's so good against the run. Think back to Week 18. With that 17-point lead, they weren't able to run the ball and take time off the clock, and it's really one of the reasons why San Francisco was able to get back in it.
On third down, pass is incomplete for Jefferson, but a flag on Ambry Thomas, it appears. And it's against the 49ers.
Yeah, you see the grab. Ambry Thomas, who...
pass interference. Number 20. Defense. Automatic.
That's a good call. Didn't let him out of his break. But Ambry Thomas really came on strong. He had the game-clinching interception against the Rams in the last game of the season. And just has gotten better and better. And I know they're glad to have him back. Not only has he done a good job in coverage here over the last month or so, but he's also been really good in run support. And if you're going to play for this 49ers defense and D'Amico Ryans, it doesn't matter what position you play. If you're a corner, a cover corner, it doesn't matter. You're going to get in there and make some plays in the run game.
Here's Akers. Greenlaw. Gain of four.
There's a look at D'Amico Ryans in his first year as defensive coordinator, replacing Robert Saleh after he got the head coaching job in New York. And things started out a little bit rough to begin the season, but made a lot of nice moves as the season went along. And the biggest, when they put Eric Armstead inside when they lost Javon Kinlaw. And that's really when this defense began to take off. They started getting after the quarterback, started getting some takeaways. It's been an entirely different unit.
The toss to Akers right side, broke one tackle. And a decent pickup as Fred Warner makes the stop. Gain of four there.
Fred Warner coming off a monster game against Green Bay, an all-pro player last year. And his season, much like this defense, got off to a slow start. But he's back to all-pro form now. Of course, we saw him earlier get away with that headbutt on Matthew Stafford, which would have been devastating on that play.
You hear the crowd noise for the Rams while they're on offense. A lot written and said about what we all witnessed here in Week 18 with a heavy 49er crowd in the home of the Rams. And a timeout taken by Los Angeles with 34 seconds left in quarter number one. We're back after this from Progressive.
How do they fit?
I don't know, Dad. I'm not comfortable trying on pants.
Oh, come on. I bet they look sharp.
You don't know who else has tried them on.
Let me take a look.
Switch to Progressive and you can save hundreds. You know, like the sign says.
Oh, that's a handsome pair of jeans right there.
This drive started at the three. Third down and two. Just outside their own 27 for the Rams. Handoff is to Michelle, and he's able to plow forward for the first down.
Well, Sony Michelle averaged over 4 yards a carry. He was the workhorse. They went out and made the trade for him when they lost Cam Akers back in camp with that Achilles injury. But, boy, when Cam Akers came back the last game of the season, they worked him in a little bit. But the postseason, it has pretty much been all Cam Akers. But Sony Michelle can do some good things.
That's the end of the quarter with no score. So it's been a defensive battle here through one. We're back after this from your local Fox station. No score after one. Rams have done a nice job to get out from the shadow of their end zone and get the ball out just across their own 30. Here's a toss to Akers. And a nice gain on first down as Bosa comes down to make the stop. Got a good block from Cooper Kupp. No surprise, a gain of six and down to Aaron Andrews.
And here's the update on tight end Tyler Higbee. Joe, we think it's right about here that he injured his knee. They're saying he's questionable to return. We were here week 18 when he injured his knee, went into the blue tent, came out, scored a touchdown, waiting for him to still come out of the locker room.
Being helped there by Neil Elitrosh. Into that blue medical tent. In good hands and hopefully able to return. Second down, four. Throw to Beckham. First down as he's able to get through Ambry Thomas in game five.
That's a big part of this game plan for the Los Angeles Rams is the ability to get the ball out of Stafford's hands quickly. Not sit back there in the pocket. Sean McVay thought that when he went back and looked at the first two games that they just tried too many times to take shots down the field, and it puts a lot of pressure on your offensive line. As good as this group is in pass protection, it's a formidable group for San Francisco, and that being the biggest challenge with Nick Bosa. But be patient, get the ball out, stay ahead of the chains is kind of the approach. Stafford had to pull it down, and now to the sideline, throws it away.
Number one overall pick in 2009 by the Lions, Matt Stafford. His record there, 0-3 in the postseason. Traded to the Rams January 31st, 2021 for multiple draft picks, including two first-rounders. And well, he and his team went 12-5, 2-0 this postseason. First time he's been in a championship game. He came in with a passer rating of over 130 through two games. And this one comes out of his hand right into the turf. Picked up and returned, but it certainly looked like it was an incomplete pass. For now, they're saying touchdown.
Yeah, all the officials, they let it play itself out. I'm with you, Joe. I thought it was definitely an incomplete pass. I'm surprised. We'll take a look.
Early on the field is an incomplete pass. Third down.
So it's an incomplete pass. And Mike Pereira, since you're here, we'll just check in with you. That looked like the hand was going forward.
Yeah, I think it was going forward, and he hadn't started down with the hand yet, the old tuck play. Hand is still moving forward when he loses possession, so it's a clear incomplete pass.
Brings up third and 10.
And I guess until you win it all as a quarterback, there's always going to be those questions as to, you know, can you win the big one and all that goes with that. I personally think it's time to put that to bed as it relates to Matthew Stafford, what he's done on a big stage in the wild card and divisional rounds, especially last week with the game knotted up on the road against Tom Brady. Played outstanding.
Third down, steps up and will take off and get the first down. Ran for just 43 yards during the regular season. This time he carries for 14.
Well, you got Kaywan Williams, who's locked up then on Cooper Kupp. They double the outside to the right, and you're going to see how things open up then for Matthew Stafford. He's not a guy who takes off and runs. Typically, when he escapes the pocket, he's looking to throw the football, but he saw it, and he took it.
Pass is incomplete for Sony Michel. That 14-yard run by Matthew Stafford a season long, and a good time for it on third and 10.
No question, and you're going to get some of those things because of the way this pass rush comes after you. There's going to be some lanes at times, and Stafford makes a veteran play and picks up a nice game.
Cam Akers for the Rams has gone to the locker room, we're told. We'll find out why. Blanton, the last remaining tight end on the roster active, picks up 10 and a first down.
Well, Kendall Blanton, they keep him in, and he's going to help in protection, and that's to help afford some time for Stafford when they want to get the ball down the field. But they covered everything up. Blanton comes out late. He's your check down. Ends up being a good play. There's a lot of room against these zone teams, especially with the weapons, with Kupp and Odell Beckham and Van Jefferson. There's going to be a lot of those underneath throws that are open for him.
Hand off to Michelle, and he's brought down in the backfield by Nick Bosa. A loss of three.
Well, when you put Odell Beckham Jr. on him, that's advantage Nick Bosa. Here he is right here. And they try to bring Odell Beckham to help cut him off. There's just no chance. I mean, that's what Cooper Kupp's supposed to do. Isn't that his job? That's what Odell Beckham's thinking right now.
I think they're drawing straws to find out who's going to block Nick Bosa. Second and 13 now. The pass caught by Kupp in traffic. He takes it inside the 30. Brought down by DJ Jones. And again, an injury update with Aaron.
Yeah, two big weapons for the Rams now questionable to return. Running back Cam Akers questionable with that shoulder injury. We've been talking about how he's just returned from the Achilles. And of course, he joins Tyler Higbee, who's questionable with the knee.
Player down for the 49ers now. And I think it's Dre Greenlaw. And it is. Bothered by a groin injury the majority of the year, they check on him. We'll take a break before third and six. Welcome back to the NFC Championship game presented by Intuit TurboTax Live. Third down and six for the Rams. 15th play of this drive. Stafford throws, looking for Kopp, and he hits him coming out of his break. First down, Rams.
You can see in the pocket, we talked about the 49er faithful that's here. He goes silent count. You see him raise his foot. Got to be pretty defeating for the home team in an NFC Championship game to have to use silent count. But it's something that a lot of these teams around the league are so good at when they do have to go on the road that they're not going to let it bother them. Execute as though you would if you're in an opposing stadium. But Matthew Stafford delivers a strike on a well-run route to Cooper Kupp to pick up that third down.
Stafford brought down, sacked by Bosa. Finishing up a great regular season with his 15 and a half sacks with a good postseason, gets one here.
It's so good. You see, once he comes up, he's going to get the edge, and then he sees Stafford. He's got eyes on him, and immediately he comes off of Rob Havenstein, the right tackle, and then makes a play. I tell you, Chris Kocurek, their defensive line coach, he has done a terrific job with everybody, and they've got an amazing rotation to where they go 8-9 guys that they just keep rotating them off the bench, keep them fresh. This is a relentless group.
Here's Michelle. Gets a yard, maybe two. Abukam, former Ram, was in there for the 49ers. Not alone. It's third and long.
Yeah, you look at this game up to this point and how good the Rams have moved the ball, and yet no points on the board. And another third down opportunity to see if San Francisco can come up with a stop and minimize what they give up on this possession.
We've had three third down conversions on this drive. Now faced with their longest third down, third and 13. Stafford, end zone, Kupp. He's got it. Touchdown, Rams.
You see Cooper Kupp as he comes off the line of scrimmage. He just doesn't give anything away until he's going to the corner. They're in a two-deep shell, and so this is the weakness. Right there behind that corner and then in front of the safety. And because he doesn't tip anything off, he has to hold, and he's not able to jump it. Just perfect execution on third and long.
By the numbers, that's the best drive the Rams have had this year. In plays, yards, and time. 18 play drive, 97 yards in the first points of this championship game. Well, Cooper Kupp is the first receiver to go over 2,000 receiving yards in a season. And he and Matthew Stafford combined to convert the last two third downs, and that touchdown throw was absolutely perfect.
It was a great throw. It was really poor play by the rookie, Ambry Thomas. We'll go back and take a look at it as to the mistake that he made.
Deebo Samuel back to return it, but it's over his head and back to the touchdown.
So Ambry Thomas is right here. It's third and 13. They're going to run to the flat here, but he's got to slough off and take that away. Make him come underneath to Sony Michel and then come up and make a play. But on third and 13, you're hoping that you can hold the corner with the flat route by the back. But if you're aware of down and distance, as the corner, you're not biting on that route, and you're not able to then get the ball in behind Cooper Kupp. But it was a really good route. Like I said, he held Jaworski tart and didn't allow him to jump it the way that he would have liked to.
The 49ers have had the ball for only 5 minutes in this game. Here's Samuel trying to get him involved. He gets two. It's So the 49ers, no offensive touchdowns in the last six-plus quarters. They got that special teams touchdown that tied the game at Green Bay on the block punt last Saturday night. Rams fans get into it and make noise for the 49ers on offense, second and eight. Garoppolo, Ayuk, hit in stride, and he just couldn't stay in bounds. He was gone, but his momentum carried him out, and a completion of 31 yards.
Oh, man, that was close to being a house call. It's a good read, good release there by Brandon Ayuk, and talk about a guy who has come on. Hey, it was close, him trying to tightrope the sideline and see if he couldn't maintain his balance, and it was going to be 6 points. But you go back the last time these two teams met, he was their leading receiver. He had over 100 yards receiving in that game, and there's so much attention paid to Deebo Samuel. The fact that Ayuk has come on the way that he has here over the last four or five ball games has really helped this offense.
And that's going to be 5 yards.
Ball start from the 71 offense. 5 yard penalty. First down.
That was either going to be a false start or a delay of game. And they get the false start call against Trent Williams, the 9-time Pro Bowl tackle.
Right down here, you see the movement. How about that play last week when he climbed up at the wing position and went in motion? You know that he's been wanting that play to get run all year long. It's been in the game plan for a while. They finally broke it out.
First down and 15 now. And they hand to Mitchell, who breaks partially through one tackle and gets three. Well, these two coaches know each other very well. Kyle Shanahan, Sean McVay coached together in Washington from 2010 to 13. Both were hired as head coaches in 2017. McVay won three of the first four matchups. Shanahan has won the last six. When Shanahan left, McVay became the OC in Washington.
A lot of respect amongst those two guys right there. Offensive minds, two of the best in football.
Second and 12, Samuel, wide receiver screen. Good play, big play, and in for the touchdown. He led the league in yards after the catch, and this for 44, he does it all.
Well, it was set up perfectly. You got 49ers, the offensive line. It's the wide receiver screen. Get the ball out. They allow the rushers to get in on Garoppolo. And then it's just off to the races. Deebo Samuel, a hard guy to get down on the ground in the open field. He makes a couple guys miss. A big-time run and a big-time play.
And a 7-7 game. Nice answer by the 49ers. And they go to number 19. Triple threat, quadruple threat, whatever you want to call him. He does it literally all. And offensive coordinator Mike McDaniel, he just got one. 7-7. Deebo Samuel now with 11 touchdowns scored in the last 11 games. Plus, he had a touchdown pass here week 18. The Juwan Jennings, who threw a nice block on that wide receiver screen, and he can return kicks. Just sensational. Return here by Powell. And Brandon Powell is not able to make it to the 25, back to the score.
Well, it was set up really well. The Rams brought pressure to the right side, but these three right here, center, guard, tackle, and Alex Mack, the center, he makes a heck of a block on Nick Scott, number 33, right there. Bam! That knocks him on his rear end and allows Samuel to run. He makes some people miss, but just a good call by Kyle Shanahan. Excellent execution. And Deebo Samuel, I mean, that guy's been balling all year. It's pretty impressive what he's been able to do for this offense, especially once he started running the ball more week 10 against these Rams.
Cam Akers in the game. You heard Aaron say left with a shoulder injury, and he gets half a yard here. Jordan Willis made that stop. Next Sunday at 6 p.m. Eastern, the Clash opens the NASCAR season with the must-see event at the fabled L.A. Coliseum. And on February 20th, the Great American Race, the Daytona 500, returns all right here on Fox. Second and nine. Stafford throws and short of Cup coming out of his break and got pressure, Stafford did, from Kevin Givens.
Oh, man, Kevin Givens, another guy who's been playing lights out, and that's why that ball was incomplete, because another good route by Cup, but he gets hit just as he's trying to turn this thing loose. He's right here in the middle. And here he comes right into the face of Stafford.
Free agent from Penn State and part of that rotation on this outstanding defensive front you talked about a moment ago.
If Stafford has time, there's an advantage for the Rams with the skill players against this secondary, but it's been that way most games for the 49ers.
Third down here. Stafford throws. Beckham with a first down catch. Good throw, good catch. As they barely got that play away, and Stafford under pressure again.
Yeah, you see that a good route versus man coverage from Mosley and Stafford. These are the throws I talked about coming into this game. You got to be willing to hang in there under pressure and deliver the ball on the money at critical times. There's a lot of that that's going to happen, and we've seen it already from Stafford. But I thought that he had to deal with that throughout the ball game against Tampa. And he did a heck of a job just hanging in there and making plays.
Under five to go, first half. Hand off to Akers. And a gain of nine on first down. Got a good block from Kendall Blanton, who is the last remaining tight end available for Sean McVay and the Rams. Time of possession, you can see what's happening with ball control. But a 7-7 game.
Yeah, it usually goes the other way. When you look at the six-game win streak by San Francisco, they pretty much dominated time of possession. And the Rams have taken a page out of their game plan.
Rams with 64 rush yards in the game. Akers adds to it and gets a first down. 49ers have held the opposition to 100 rush yards in 10 of their last 11 games. But some success on the ground here for the Rams in this first half.
Well, that's a good sign, because if they're running the ball with some success in the first half, it should translate to even a little more success in the second half.
Stafford, Cup dropped it. He had his eyes on the end zone. And a rare Cooper Cup drop.
Boy, and the 49ers are playing a little more man coverage than what I've seen from them also. And you've got Kaywan Williams locked up on him, and Cup is able to play through that. And you don't see that very often. But he had a lot of field out in front of him if he makes that catch.
Boy, I'll say.
Stafford knew it.
Second down, Cup makes the diving catch. They'll mark him short of first down yardage. Third down coming up.
You knew immediately that's where Stafford was going to go with the football. So on first down, they were locked up in man coverage. Cup drops the ball. Second down, they go zone, a soft zone. No collision on Cup off the line, and he'll hit that all day long.
Rams have converted five straight third down tries. Michelle got it. Four yards on third down and less than one.
Cooper Kupp, he does it all. And we've seen this over and over. It's what has impressed me probably most, the unselfishness. A lot of players that fall into that mode for both teams.
Stafford going for it all. Skoranek dropped it. Jimmy Ward was back there, had no idea where the ball was, and Skoranek just missed his chance for a touchdown.
Well, Stafford had whoever he wanted. He could have come out to Kupp. Instead, he's got the home run shot to Skoranek. Jimmy Ward didn't know where the ball was being thrown. He was nowhere there. Stafford makes a great read. Jimmy Ward's thinking he's going to come back and hit Kupp on the boundary. And Stafford had his choice. That's two now. Here's Kupp in the middle. He's coming out to the boundary. He was wide open as well. So you turn two guys loose. They had the home run for the touchdown, and they don't get anything.
Second and 10, and they hand to Akers. Brought down by Bosa for a gain of two, and now we're headed toward the two-minute warning. And a third and long for the Rams, who are thinking about what might have been. What is to come is on the other side of the two-minute warning. Third down and eight. Here's the drop by Skoranek, the rookie from Notre Dame. Stafford almost couldn't connect. Is it okay, Troy, if I use your Telestrator here?
Okay. Absolutely. Help yourself.
L.A. hockey royalty right there. Jarrett Stahl, Matt Green.
There's old Trudy Buck. Allie yes. Anthony.
They're down at eight. 2 minutes left in the half. 7-7 game. Stafford launches. Beckham is out of bounds. And with pressure by Ebukam, Stafford just heaved it to bring up fourth and eight. And Stafford again comes away a bit gimpy.
Yeah, he's definitely feeling the pressure back there in the pocket as he's hobbling off a little bit. There was a lot of contact down the field. You see him get rolled up on. I think that based on where that throw was, just not a catchable ball. But Ambry Thomas was banging on him pretty good.
54-yard try by Matt Gay. Wide right. And with a minute 50 left in the half and three timeouts, the 49ers will have great field position at their own 44 in a tie game. NFC Championship in Inglewood. Well, Deebo Samuel became one of three players and the only wide receiver in NFL history to have at least 1,000 receiving yards, five receiving touchdowns, and five or more rushing touchdowns in a single season. The other two running backs, Roger Craig, 49er in 85, and Marshall Faulk with the St. Louis Rams in 1999. Wes Welker, his position coach, you know him well.
Yeah, he's been in a few big games over the years. Pretty good guy to be tutoring Deebo Samuel.
Here is Deebo, left side, not much. Well played by A'shaun Robinson. And down to Tom Rinaldi we go.
Joe, we talk so much about how Jimmy Garoppolo has the support of his teammates. Here, this was Thursday, a tweet sent out by Deebo Samuel. Crazy how y'all have so much to say about our quarterback. Check his win percentage. Okay, I'll wait. Pure winner. Garoppolo came into the team building unaware that that tweet had even been sent out. Teammates had to tell him. As for Samuel, he shows that he goes public with that support, and that's what we hear constantly, don't we, guys, about the way this team rallies around Jimmy Garoppolo, despite the outside narrative.
Yep, no doubt about it. Second down and eight here with just over a minute to go and three timeouts.
They're going to rush this one to get it off. They do.
Garoppolo over the middle. Samuel gets blown up and flags on the play on the hit by Nick Scott. And now you just have to hope that Debo's okay.
I thought it was clean when I saw it in real time. We'll take a look. I don't know. I don't know if that's looks like he hits him down around the shoulders. And yeah, that's textbook. That's the way the league coaches it up. That's what they want to see.
There's no foul for illegal hit on a defenseless receiver. third down.
This, as we know, he's the heartbeat of this offense. They lose all kinds of stuff off that play sheet if he's unable to go.
Hopefully he's okay. They check on him. They pick up the flag. Third and eight when we come back. With 49er fans in attendance chanting Debo during the break, Debo Samuel popped up and went off the field. Appears to be fine after that hit in the chest by Nick Scott. 49ers charged a timeout. And it's third down and eight. 0 for 2 on third down in the game. This one high, but caught. First down, Kittle. His first catch. And Eric Weddle, who came out of retirement, ends up making the tackle.
No, the Rams bring a fifth rusher, and they're locked up. And Kittle, just a good release. He's getting up the way the combination led. They're able to put it right on him, and a big third down conversion.
Timeout, San Francisco. What's coming up at the half?
Coming up on the Verizon Halftime, Terry, Michael, Howie, and Jimmy will give their view of the first half, and the Bengals earned a spot to play here in the Super Bowl. We'll hear what Joe Burrow had to say to Christina Peake after the game. That's all coming up at the half.
Kurt, thanks. We just saw, Troy, only the fifth first down for the 49ers in this half, yet here they are with under a minute to go, one timeout, first down, a chance to take the lead, and they get the ball to start the second half.
And that's how they were able to climb back in that game week 17. They got a field goal before the half, they got the ball to start the third quarter, went down and got a touchdown. And this first half, this is 49ers football. I mean, they're in their element in this type of game, the way that it's unfolded.
Debo back in there, Hasty, his first play. Jermichael makes the catch and the run and takes it inside the 40 for 6.
You know, you make a stop on third down that George Kittle gets, and you're punting the ball to the Rams. The Rams have a chance to maybe get something going. Now the 49ers do.
Ayuk, good throw. First down inside the 25. And the 49ers will hurry back to the line with 21 seconds left and clock it with 20 to go in the half.
Yeah, these are the plays when you've needed these throws late in halves. This is when Jimmy seems to kind of be at his best, when you've got a little bit of an up-tempo and he just lets it go. And here's Brandon Ayuk once again. And right at the end of this play, Scott trips him up. There was a chance that if he doesn't make that play, really by the shoestrings, that Ayuk takes that the distance also.
Three catches, 56 yards for Ayuk. He's really matured and grown this year. Second and 10. Garoppolo steps through, and the clock will continue to run as he's knocked down at the 21. And now the 49ers will use their last timeout.
Yeah, it looks like they're going to let it run down and just settle for the 3 points here.
Trying to get the lead before the half, and then they get the ball to start the second half as this ball came out, but after Garoppolo was down.
Nice job there on third down, the conversion. Now the hit on Debo Samuel. Garoppolo was a little late on the throw. Looks like, you know, Samuel, he's going to be okay, but a good job to be able to put yourself in a position to come away with points, take the lead here at halftime.
38-yard try by Robbie Gould. He hit the game-winning 45-yarder on that frigid night at Green Bay last Saturday night for the win.
This should be a walk in the park compared to that.
And it is now 21 of 21 in his postseason career. And that's the most all-time without a miss as Jalen Ramsey gets in his face before the two teams head off and head into the locker room. Take a look at today's insights built with IBM Watson. We'll remind you of the kind of year that Cooper Kupp has had the most scrimmage yards by a wide receiver in a single season all time, including the postseason. Tops on that list. Good first half. Physical, hard-nosed football. 10-7 San Francisco. The Rise in halftime coming up after this from your local Fox station.
Welcome to the Verizon Halftime, the official 5G network of the NFL.
Well, in a game where there are just a few more 49er fans than the hometown Rams fans, the 49ers have a few more points in the first half. Deebo Samuel and San Francisco up 10-7 here in the NFC Championship game as we welcome you to the Verizon Halftime Show. Kurt and the gang here live from Los Angeles. And Jimmy, this 49er team, we talked about how tough, how resilient they are. They scored 10 straight points after Cooper Kupp of the Rams took the lead.
Yeah, Kurt, Cooper Kupp is so good. You know, not only did he lead the league in receiving, he is a tremendous route runner. Here he has a little comeback here, catches the football. He did have one drop, but other than that, he was perfect. Another out route is for 15 yards, and this is the thing of beauty. He runs at the safety. He freezes the safety. He catches it in the corner for the touchdown. He's really just a great player.
But, you know, their answer to Cooper Kupp and Deebo Samuel on the other side of the ball. And just what we talk about, his physicality. Here he catches the screen and just weaves his way through, pushes off, stiff arm, and then the acceleration to get to the end zone and reach out for the touchdown. That just took a lot of air out of the sail of the Rams.
Yeah, we talked about the defensive front led by Nick Bosa and Eric Armstead. They really, the front four dictates terms for this team. Bosa here on the screen pass, gets out, hustle play, breaks up the play. Here on the run stop, Odell Beckham Jr. blocking Bosa, that's a mismatch. And here, he gets the sack on 25 dropbacks. The 49ers, true to form, have only blitzed two times.
You know, it's kind of interesting. In football games like this, you think the team that has the ball the most, runs the most plays, is going to have the lead. That's not the case. It's really the Rams are 22 plays more than the 49ers. And Howie and I were talking right before we came on air, and it seems like Jimmy Garoppolo is much more effective when they just turn him loose. He's not structured.
Of course, the winner of this game goes on in the Super Bowl. We know that the Cincinnati Bengals are already there. Joe Burrow, will we hear from him when we come back? But right now, as the Chainsmokers perform and we continue our coverage of the NFC title game and the National Football League, the NFL's most prestigious honor, the Walter Payton Man of the Year Award, recognizes NFL players who not only have exhibited excellence on the field, but whose passion to impact lives extend beyond the game and has led them to leave a positive legacy in their communities. Well, in honor of their outstanding achievements, fans were encouraged to show support for their favorite nominee on social media through the 7th annual Walter Payton NFL Man of the Year Charity Challenge. We're excited to announce that Kansas City Chiefs safety Tyrann Mathieu is the winner of this year's charity challenge, having received the most fan hashtag mentions over the last month in support of his charitable work. Tyrann will receive $25,000 to his charity of choice. All Man of the Year nominees will be celebrated, and the winner of this year's award will be announced live at NFL Honors on Thursday, February 10th at 9 p.m. Eastern. That will be broadcast on ABC, ESPN Plus, and NFL Network. When we continue, more from here in Los Angeles and Joe Burrow with Christina Pink as he's gotten the Cincinnati Bengals into the Super Bowl for the first time in more than three decades.
Today's game flow brought to you by Progressive and the music of the Chainsmokers, who gave a great show here at the half. 10-7 game, San Francisco on top and about to get the ball to start the second half. Joe Buck, and Troy Aikman are here with you. And you said it going to break, and you read my mind, that we've seen a lot of the 49ers here of late. That is the way they play football. And that first half ended really, really in San Francisco's favor.
No, that's that was a great way for them to finish the half. What's interesting is if you look at the Rams, they did what you would hope to do defensively. The 49ers ran the ball just 8 times for 19 yards. Now, if you told anybody that the 49ers would run for only 19 yards in the first half, you couldn't have imagined that they would be leading this game, but yet here they are.
And they get the ball as Samuel will bring it from inside the 5. And he gets hit hard, shy of the 20. Agbenaya Okwunkwo is there to make the stop for the Rams. 15-yard return. Down to Aaron Andrews we go.
Sean McVay happy with that hit. Sean McVay right now with his defense would like to see them communicate a little better. He felt like they were a little too loose there in the first half. He said we weren't aligned on some plays, and he mentioned the word finish. Offensively, happy with the way his team handled the line of scrimmage, like the way they ran the ball, like the tempo. Again, use the word finish. I will tell you an update there for this offense of the Rams. Wide receiver Van Jefferson questionable with a knee injury.
Yeah, so they're getting some big weapons here who are hurt. Higby leading the way there as Garoppolo throws back across the field and nearly picked by Ramsey. Samuel the target, and that was a dangerous throw that Garoppolo got away with.
Well, the 49ers fans, it's a little stressful if you're a 49ers fan watching Jimmy Garoppolo at times. It is a roller coaster ride when he gets the ball, especially outside the pocket, trying to come back into the middle. And that's the second throw now. And I showed Troy Reader there in that first half who had a chance. That time Ramsey.
Samuel gets it on a handoff to the 24 and down to Tom Rinaldi.
Well, Joe, Kyle Shanahan, as you might imagine, excited about their ability to score before the end of the first half, but said we need to find ways to extend drives to help out the defense. He noted the huge advantage in time of possession for the Rams. Also said if we lose Dre Greenlaw, who's working, trying to work through a calf injury, that'd be huge for us. As for the two words, he echoed Aaron Andrews and Sean McVay, fight and finish, fight and finish.
Time of possession. Rams have doubled up the 49ers, 3rd and 4.
There's Debo Samuel across from Darius Williams.
Great gains came across. That could be a first down by penalty if it's against 91.
Neutral zone infraction, number 91, defense, 5-yard penalty, results. Wow. First down.
That look on Sean McVay's face says it all. Right over the ball. You can see there. They're using the silent count as well, San Francisco and Gaines. That's a tough one.
That is the first Rams penalty of the game. But it gives the 49ers a first down at their own 29. Low snap. Hand off to Samuel. A little room this time. He gets 9. Almost before the kickoff to the second half, Robbie Gould is drilling this through the Rams. Well, he was caught kicking over the Packers last week. This is what happened at the end of the half here today. But last week, while the Packers were being announced, he was out there trying field goals over their head.
Hey, I don't blame. He's going to get his kicks in, whether you like it or not.
Here's a handoff to Mitchell, who's got a first down.
Apparently, Ramsey didn't like it too much.
Tom Rinaldi.
Talking to Robbie Gould this week, exactly, guys. He said, nothing's going to get in the way of me having to do what I need to do. Back in Dallas, he kicked over the heads of the cheerleaders last week in Green Bay over the defensive introductions. And he was one of the loudest voices running down the hall into the locker room, exhorting his teammates here. Obviously, we know he's perfect in the postseason. No announcer or jinx, but a leader on this team, Robbie Gould.
We talk about how tough the 49ers are. It permeates even into the kicking game.
Here's Garoppolo. He's able to get rid of it to the sideline and avoid the sack by Okwunkwo. There's a flag now down in the secondary. Carl Sheffers first made the announcement.
Illegal contact, number 5, defense, 5-yard penalty, automatic, first down.
First announcement was there's no flag for intentional grounding, and then was alerted that there was illegal contact by Jalen Ramsey, and another first down by penalty, just outside their own 45 now.
Yeah, a little bit of a double move, and there was the contact right there as Ayuk's trying to get up inside of it. Ramsey, of course, doesn't like it. They were able to get pressure. Juszczyk unable to make the block. But they get a new set of downs.
Garoppolo locked on Mitchell all the way. And Elijah Mitchell gets another 49er first down. An 11-yard completion.
They get the ball to the flat, but I think that's Jalen Ramsey on the out. Can't tell who that is on the outside. No, it's Darius Williams. They totally bust coverage that if Garoppolo is able to pump him to the flat, they got a chance for a home run. Williams came off of his guy a little early.
Here's Mitchell getting a yard. Eric Weddle, who's a fantastic story, came out of retirement, his third game back with the Rams. And it was really defensive coordinator Raheem Morris who kept in touch with Eric Weddle. And when Taylor Rapp went down with a concussion and Jordan Fuller went on IR with an ankle, he put a call out. And here's Eric Weddle playing in the postseason, trying to help his team get to the Super Bowl.
It's pretty incredible. He was playing pickup basketball. And that's the way he was keeping himself in shape. He thought he'd play 15 to 20 snaps, which he did against Arizona. And then last week against Tampa Bay, he played the entire game.
Garoppolo is able to throw it away. They let him play on. Pressure by Leonard Floyd.
I thought we were going to see a helmet catch after that, Joe. It reminded me of Eli Manning. I'm surprised they let it go as long as they did.
Trent Williams, by the way, was slow to get up.
You see right there, Jimmy, it's amazing that he was even able to keep his feet.
Williams playing to that ankle sprain. It's third down and 9. Pass is tipped and incomplete for Kittle. And a nice job by the Rams defense to get a stop. Fourth down. See if Greg Gaines got a piece of that pass.
Greg Gaines, I mean, he's getting after it. We saw the in the neutral zone infraction that gave the 49ers a new set of downs, but he's been working it pretty good. And he's the guy when everybody's doubling up on Aaron Donald. It opens things up for him and the chance to win those one-on-one matchups.
Wisnowski, end over end. Fair catch at the 11 by Cooper Kupp. The first possession of the second half stalls for the 49ers. Here comes Stafford for the Rams, down 3. Sean McVay, the head coach of the Rams, just turned 36 this past week. There's his dad, Tim. Sweating through this while his kids trying to take the Rams to the Super Bowl. Took them there in 2018. From the 11, handoff to Kupp. Oh. And a good play by Mosley came up to make the stop and then got help from Fred Warner.
That's a good example. I mentioned it earlier about what's expected from these corners in run support. And man, Emmanuel Mosley, he comes up and he doesn't wrap up, but he certainly puts a big hit on Cooper Kupp, and then Fred Warner cleans him up.
Players down for San Francisco. Try to see who that is. It's hard to tell. We'll find out. It's Kaywan Williams, we're told. Back after this. Kaywan Williams able to get up under his own power, get to the sideline. Dante Johnson takes his spot. Second down and 12. Last time the Rams were pinned deep, They went 97 yards for their only touchdown of the game. Stafford steps up, throws, and wide open is Beckham for a first down. That's the threat of speed. As soon as you threaten a corner deep, you get him turned like Odell Beckham's able to do with Emmanuel Mosley, you got all kinds of room.
Here's what happened to Kaywan Williams.
Yeah, he gets cracked back by Odell Beckham in the ribs, and then he also got popped by... He was over getting checked out. Here is Beckham. Found a hole in this defense, and another completion to Odell Beckham, this time for 26. Kind of the same type of design. And he chews up so much ground. You see him come off the ball. He's full speed. And Mosley's just not sure exactly. He just got beat on the comeback. Now all of a sudden he runs this deeper, skinny post.
Sixth catch for Beckham.
Pass caught by Blanton.
And the tight end on first and 10. A nice gain of 9. Brought down by Thomas and Allshire.
They got the 49ers reeling a little bit. And they're running a 4-cross zone. And everybody then is trying to keep from giving up the big play. Another, trying to get underneath Beckham. And all of a sudden, Kendall Blanton's able to get the ball in the flat for a pretty easy completion.
Tyler Higbee, their starting tight end, has been ruled out after that early knee injury.
They put Van Jefferson in here to help out. Maybe chip him as he comes out. Well, they put him in motion now.
And hand off Akers. Into the arms of Gibbons. Looks to be just short of first down yardage, and he is. Third down.
Well, they're looking at four down territory here. If they're unable to pick this up.
Sean McVay had told us that they were going to go up tempo and try and really get this defensive line worn down. I haven't seen a lot of that.
They started the game with it. They went up tempo to open up the game, but yeah, they've slowed things down since the early part of this ball game.
Stafford has to throw it away. And it is fourth down. Pressure by Bosa and Jones, and it's fourth and one.
Well, you see, when Stafford goes to get under center, these guys all here, they're going to squeeze down. They're going to get into the gaps, into the A gaps off of the center, Brian Allen. And then they're going to try to come out. A little trouble with the snap. They're trying to get the ball initially right away to Cooper Kupp. This just made this conversion a lot more eventful here on fourth down.
And it is plenty loud in this stadium, the home of the Rams. Stafford. Depends where they put it.
Yeah, he got it. He barely did.
I mean, it is up to where they place it down. And we will get a measurement. Stafford, in his career, 28 for 30 on third or fourth and one rushing. And there are some anxious fans on both sides wondering if this is a first down or not.
Well, he's trying to get down low, but he just doesn't. He's not able to stay quite low enough. And they got pretty good surface on him. And you're right. It's just a matter of... matter of where this spot was when they came in.
And he is short. Wow. 49ers football.
He's going to challenge it, but I don't know. These are always hard to piece together to see whether or not it was a poor spot or not.
Well, it looked like on that replay it was a good spot, if not generous. 49ers take over as they get a stop on fourth and less than one, up three.
Today's hit is sponsored by Verizon, the official 5G network of the NFL. Verizon.
After review,
The ruling on the field stands as called. The runner is short of the line of game. First down, San Francisco.
And listen to the 49er fans. Another look at it.
Well, Charles O'Manahu, he's the guy who comes in initially and makes contact, and then here they all come, the gold helmets, and they hold him up. There's O'Manahu who makes first contact. Stafford was a little bit high and just not able to get it. Didn't think there was enough there. It's a significant enough play that I certainly understand why the challenge was made by Sean McVay, but, you know, you give up the challenge there, and right now we'll see whether or not the 49ers are able to do anything with it, but a big momentum shift.
It was second and a long one, and in three plays could not convert the first down. Here's Samuel, nothing. A'shaun Robinson made that play, and they lose the timeout. We come into every game, and Troy, any team taking on Aaron Donald and the Rams worries about big number 99. Maybe the best player in the game, but we haven't said his name much.
No, we have not. And haven't said his name much whenever he's gone against the 49ers in recent games. They have done a pretty good job. We haven't talked a lot about Von Miller or Leonard Floyd either.
Second and 10. Samuel on a toss. Broke through the tackle of Reeder. And ends up getting five. The Rams put the pads on this week on Thursday. They haven't done that in a long time in anticipation of this physical matchup. They know what they're getting with the 49ers, and here they are down by three. San Francisco third and five.
Well, that part of it, like we talked about, I mean, they've done a good job in run defense. And then on third downs, they've done a good job. I mean, this really, if you just look at the numbers compared to the way the Rams have played in other games, you'd say you're a little surprised they're behind.
Here's one to IU. Good throw, good catch, first down. Working against Darius Williams, 13 yards.
And Jimmy Garoppolo, immediately he knows that he's working IU. In a really good route, Darius Williams gets outside leverage, and he puts it right on him. I mean, this guy, to be able to do what he's been able to do when they've needed him to do it, has been excellent. Perfect timing at his acceleration here late in the year. They got Travis Benjamin in the game, number 17. He's a speedster. This guy can run. Keep an eye on him going deep.
Mitchell in the backfield. Great gains, a loss of one.
Travis Benjamin doesn't play a lot, and now he's coming out of the game. And so what I would expect, you know, he's going back in. Started to come to the sidelines, went back in the game. And I'm telling you, I would expect him to get a shot down the field. He only has one reception, but he runs a 4-3. And I think maybe they set it up with a run play there and maybe take a shot here. We'll see what happens. But here he is going back to the same spot he just was aligned at. And they've got to look if they're going to take it.
They throw to Samuel, and Debo has another first down as he takes Troy Reeder for a ride, a gain of 14.
Wow. I mean, this guy's a wide receiver. Look what he does to number 51, Troy Reeder. Reeder gets on his back, and he gets taken for a ride. I mean, that's pretty amazing. You know, a lot of times you got a tandem running back. Trent Williams getting out there. When you've got two running backs, one guy's usually the speed guy, the other guy's the thumper. What's interesting for the 49ers is Debo Samuel is that thumper when he runs the ball, and he showed it there on the catch.
10 touches, 86 yards, and a touchdown for Samuel. Now Elijah Mitchell to the line of scrimmage. That's it. Fox Tonight, don't miss TV's number one new show, a three-story culinary gauntlet that pits mentor against mentor. Can Gordon Ramsay stop his team's losing streak? It's an all-new Next Level Chef coming up next after the game on Fox.
I mean, you think about this game, Joe. They're down in there in field goal range early in the game, and Stafford gets the interception off of the deflection, and then they miss Skowronek in the end zone, which would have been a touchdown. We're talking a 10-point difference there. And now fourth down, they don't convert. And here come the 49ers with a chance to possibly extend their lead to two possessions. Garoppolo throws incomplete for Samuel. It was open over the middle. Garoppolo couldn't get it to him.
Yeah, that might have been his easiest throw of the day. He had no pressure in his face, and Jimmy's expecting Debo to stay on the run. Debo kind of starts to hook up in the zone. Brings up now third and long.
Kyle Shanahan was running down the sideline trying to call a timeout. Instead, they ran the play, and it's third and 10. Pass is caught. Jennings is going to fight for the first down. Troy, I've heard you say it a number of times, you're only as good as your third wide receiver, and they have an emerging force in Juwan Jennings.
They sure do, and he showed up big week 18. The time in the pocket, they bring pressure late. He's not able to get to Garoppolo, and there goes Juwan Jennings, and Troy Reader just not able to make the stop when he had a chance to. Pretty much a five-man protection as well, and Juszczyk chipped on the way out, but not much help.
Toss to Mitchell. Play made by Vaughn Miller, and the first time we've said his name today. Loss of one.
Yeah, they've done a number, and like we've talked about, this hasn't exactly been the way that Kyle Shanahan has done it. You know, they're right now at 17 rushes. He's hoping always to get to the magical 30 number. They had 44 week 10, but they have been able to keep some drives alive like we've seen just by sheer determination.
Second and 11. Garoppolo, end zone, Kittle! Touchdown, 49ers! First touchdown for George Kittle over the last six games.
Here you go. Kittle's right here. He's going to come here. Flat. Go. He jumps it. Safety's here. And you see why Kittle's as open as he is in the end zone. Then you just got to beat the corner who's coming off to try to make a play.
Extra point is good. Took paint with it. But it's now a 10-point game. Garoppolo finds George Kittle, and the 49ers have found a 10-point lead in the NFC Championship game. Welcome back to the NFC Championship game presented by Intuit TurboTax Live at SoFi Stadium. Aerial coverage provided by Tubi. Beautiful stadium, the stars are out, and a trip to Super Bowl 56 is on the line, and plenty of 49ers fans are here as they just let loose with that touchdown throw to George Kittle. The aforementioned stars, Rob Lowe, Cedric the Entertainer, Jessica Alba, Magic, Leo. What's up, Leo? Taking in a Rams 49ers NFC Championship game, and now the 49ers. Sounds like they're sharing this stadium with the Rams and the Chargers with the kind of support they've got. They had it in week 18, and it's just about as loud here at the end of January with a trip to the Super Bowl on the line, and a flag comes down at the end of that play. Completion to Cup.
Yeah, they're huddled up. That came in late.
After the play is over, unsportsmanlike conduct, taunting, number 51 defense. 15 yards will be added to the end of the play. Automatic first down.
Azeez Allshire.
Yeah, it was after this took place, and then after they got up, and then the official had signaled for the clock to keep rolling, and then they got Alshire for right at the end of this. Not a lot there, but whatever it was enough.
It moves the ball out past the 46. Well, here's Matthew Stafford. Rams spent a lot of capital to bring number 9 from Detroit to win this type game and now to overcome a 10-point deficit with a minute and a half to go in quarter number 3. Hands the ball to Michelle. And Sony, a late add right before the regular season began, gets 2. Former New England Patriot.
Yeah, pretty tough sledding tonight for Sony Michel. Cam Akers has had a little more success, but, you know, still try to run the football and slow down this pass rush that the 49ers are capable of putting on Stafford.
Matthew lets it fly. He's got Cup. Breaks the tackle and gets a first down. Went through Emmanuel Mosley and gets 11, maybe 12.
Yeah, good protection here. They chip on the way out on Bosa and get the ball to Cup. He's going to get his targets. He's going to get his catches, and it's that right there. Of course, they're rallying. You've got Kaywan Williams who comes over and helps make a play, but the run after the catch is where Cup is so dangerous.
Play clock at 10. And the Rams have to hurry here.
Yeah, they were slow. Stafford was a little slow getting out of the huddle.
And they have to use their second timeout. Wow. Down to 1 timeout, trailing by 10, and we're back after this from Verizon.
Verizon is going ultra, and so is your home internet. That's right, 5G is not just for phones. Welcome to 5G Home, with blazing fast 5G ultra-wideband now in many more cities.
I'm ordering pizza.
Yeah, I can eat.
What's our new address?
I don't know. Look at that. Just plug and play, it's wireless home internet. See ya, cable. And look here, Mary's got 5G Home too. Ultra fast, ultra simple, and 50% off with her unlimited plan. What do you say to that?
Shh, right, you enjoy that internet.
Verizon is going ultra, so you can too.
It's a huge timeout right there by the Los Angeles Rams as the clock was running down. They're now down to 1 timeout in what will prove to be a tight game. And, you know, do you let the clock run out and take a 5-yard penalty? I don't think you do. It's first down, but I don't think you do. But that could prove very costly.
We'll toss back to Stafford, and now a throw to Branton, the tight end. A lot of room. Down inside the 20. 20 yards to Kendall Blanton. And that's how the third quarter comes to a close. Rams on the move, down by 10. And anybody here or on TV getting their money's worth. For this matchup, trip to the Super Bowl on the line. Back after this from your local Fox station. Well, 15 minutes left. A look at the two quarterbacks and their numbers starting to even out. You see the passer rating for Garoppolo, who at the moment has his team up by 10. First down for the Rams. Just outside the 20 of the 49ers.
Odell Beckham one-on-one with a lot of field to this boundary.
Play action from Stafford and another catch for Blanton. And Blanton is going to get 9. It's his fourth catch, 49 yards. That's more in this one game than he had the entire regular season.
Yeah, Kendall Blanton, this is how he got freed up on the previous play, the big gain down the middle on the tight end screen, and he's helping on Nick Bosa. He gets out, and Stafford's able to get him the ball. Last week, he got the touchdown catch, of course. He also split out wide and was able to catch a ball. He's a pretty versatile guy, and they've needed him, and he's made some plays during this game.
Hand off to Michelle, and he lost half a yard. Emmanuel Mosley came up to make the stop.
Well, now you're, I mean, Sean McVay's over there on the sideline saying, you've got to be kidding me. They've got second and short. Now they're third and short. And if they don't make it here, you got to believe he's, I don't know what to believe, but I would think he'd take the field goal and cut it to a one-possession game, but this is not what he had in mind when it got to second and short. We'll see if they're able to pick this one up.
Out of the shotgun, at least at the start of the play. Third down and one. Stafford, end zone, caught, got it, touchdown Rams.
You see Matthew Stafford having to use the silent count down in here close to the goal line and in the red zone, and just an outstanding route. He got Kaywan Williams just turned all around for that touchdown reception.
Extra point is good, and it's a three-point game. Number nine looks for number 10. And this great connection continues. NFC Championship game, three-point affair in Inglewood. Welcome back to the NFC Championship game presented by Intuit TurboTax Live. Down to a three-point game at Cooper Cup. Eight catches, 93 yards, and two third-down touchdown receptions in the game. Debo Samuel will tiptoe down the sideline and get to the 14. That's it. Well played by the Rams. Buddy Howell downfield to make the stop.
He kind of gets thrown off as he's trying to stay in bounds, and just great coverage by the Rams kick coverage team to get down there and make a play on Debo Samuel as he's trying to take it all the way across to the other side of the field.
49ers got off to a 3-5 start. They've won 9 of 11 since, and three hard-fought road games in a row to get here. 13 and a half to go, up by three. Garoppolo wide open is Mitchell. Full head of steam, and Elijah Mitchell brought down at the 35 by Reeder. Big play to start this possession for Garoppolo in San Francisco.
Well, the Rams run a match zone when a guy comes into their area. You can see Reeder here as he comes out and that he's able to get away from. So Reeder's coming up to make a play, and he just completely overruns it. And then it turns into a big play on just a check down because the linebackers overplayed it. Reeder's had a tough second half. He got carried for a couple first downs on third, and then that time gives up the big play to Mitchell.
21 yards. Low throw, and it skips into Ayuk. Let's go down to Aaron Andrews.
Joe, this is what happened when the Los Angeles Rams gave up a touchdown. Aaron Donald doesn't speak a lot to his teammates, speak up, but when he does, they all listen. He told us this week, this is what I wanted, to play against this team, a team we do not care for a chance to go to the Super Bowl, and you guys heard it in his voice. He said, it's the one thing I'm lacking, that Super Bowl win. I want that ring.
The Rams have yet to post a sack. Here he is right here, 99.
Second and 10, Garoppolo, Samuel, Debo, full head of steam. He knew where the sticks were and just put his head down and barreled through two defenders to get the first down.
Yeah, so they work the center. They're going to work to Aaron Donald. You see Alex Mack, number 50, they're going to try to double him. He almost is able to split it, but Garoppolo has good pocket presence. He feels it, and again, he just gets the ball out and let Debo Samuel do his thing.
Garoppolo 6-0 as the 49ers quarterback against the Rams.
Now Donald is lined up over right guard Daniel Brunskill.
Mitchell, right up the gut, got nine. Nick Scott, the safety, made the tackle.
Yeah, George Kittle, we saw him. He's able to make the touchdown catch on the previous possession, and this time he helps lead the way on a pretty nice game. A lot of versatility amongst this 49ers group. You see the job he does, it helps spring them. And I would, you know, second and short here, I would have to believe run it. Maybe you try to do hard play action, but it just feels like this offensive line starting to feel it a little bit, and Kyle Shanahan starts feeding the running game.
Which they do, and it doesn't work. Play made in the backfield as Eric Weddle came up to make the stop at a loss of one on Elijah Mitchell.
Yeah, they're trying to crack on him, and Eric Weddle, one of the smartest guys to ever play on the defensive side of the ball. And he hit it perfectly, timed it out, makes a play. Here he comes. They're trying to cut back on him on Trent Sherfield as the guy who was trying to make that block, but Weddle beats him to the punch.
Team high 9 tackles for Weddle. Third down and 2. There's Williams in motion again, and Juszczyk doesn't get it. Greg Gaines made that play.
We saw it last week. We talked about it. And when he goes in motion, Kyle Shanahan's thinking that that's what the Rams are going to think. They're going to rush to the edge. And you sneak the ball then to Juszczyk underneath it all, and the Rams played it perfectly. Shanahan, you can tell him, you can see he's talking to himself over there on the sidelines. Thought it was a tendency buster because of what they showed last week, and the Rams, they weren't fooled by it.
And now a challenge. That ball came out late. A challenge by Sean McVay, his second challenge of the game. And I think Sean McVay is saying that Juszczyk wasn't down.
Los Angeles is challenging the ruling on the field that the runner was down by contact. We'll review the play.
So this is it. He's got just the one timeout left. And challenging, making the case that Juszczyk fumbled, and the Rams take over here. We'll get the call when we come back.
After review, the ruling on the field stands as called. The ball is in control of the runner with his elbow down. It is fourth down. Los Angeles will be charged with a timeout. And this is their second and final review.
So they're out of challenges. They're out of timeouts. And with that stoppage, Kyle Shanahan just sent his offense back onto the field.
He's either going to try to draw him off sides, although they spent a lot of time in the huddle. I think they are going to go for it. He likes something on that call sheet if they do, but this is a pretty gutsy call. Meanwhile, it just feels like Sean McVay is chasing it a little bit with some of these challenges.
He only challenged one time all regular season. He's challenged twice in this game, and he's 0-2. And now 2-4. In his postseason career as head coach of the Rams. 4th and 2. Trying to draw him off, and it didn't work.
Delay of game. Offense. 5-yard penalty. 4th down.
That would have been the icing on the cake if they'd gotten a new set of downs there. Good job, good discipline up front by the Rams. Good idea as well. I go back to that call to Juszczyk when you put Trent Williams in motion. I like the call. I sometimes good calls and good plays don't work, but I like the idea.
Wisnowski, fair catch by Kupp. Earlier in the year, the 49ers were certainly counted out. The early season headlines, you can read them. still early, but the 49ers are a team in crisis, bombing and bomb cyclone. 49ers season turning into a washout. Kyle Shanahan has no right answers right now. And Kyle Shanahan is massively failing the 49ers, but they've won 9 out of 11. They're leading by 3 with 9:55 left, trying to get back to the Super Bowl. They were there 2 years ago on that loss to the Chiefs.
Each time they've played the Rams, they've had their backs 10-3-5. Week 18 had to win to get in. Both teams feeling the pressure tonight.
Stafford airs it out. Jefferson downfield. He's picked. No, dropped. Unbelievable. A drop by Jaquaski Tartt, and he cannot believe it. Uncontested, right into his chest, had it and lost it.
There was a hush that came over this stadium. Jaquaski Tartt, this is the desperation throws that we've seen in each of the two games by Matthew Stafford. I don't know if he's injured, but he hasn't had enough arm to really get the ball out in the two prior games when he's tried to. That ball was so badly underthrown. Jaquaski Tartt, it hits him right in the numbers.
What an opportunity for the 49ers. It doesn't pan out. And now Beckham, and he gets hit by Jimmy Ward, and that'll be 15 yards at the end of the play.
Wow, what a change of events with the drop by Tartt. And they're a big play here up the left sideline to Odell Beckham. They're going to add 15 yards to it as you're going to see Ward come in, go helmet to helmet, and just really uncalled for. Odell's already down low.
Unnecessary roughness. Number 25. Defense, that 15-yard penalty will be added to the end of the play. Automatic first down.
Well, you can mark this down with what should have been an interception, a gift, and now a 30-yard completion plus 15 yards, 45 yards of field position the Rams' way as they trail by 3.
Yeah, and one, you know, sometimes those bang-bang plays, they happen, but that wasn't one of them. I mean, Jimmy Ward saw Odell Beckham going down to the ground. He could come over and just touched him. He took a shot at him, and it was a costly penalty.
Under 9.5 to go. Hand off here to Akers, and Tartt, who missed on the interception, is back there to make the play. And I don't know how, if you're Jaquaski Tartt, how that's not running through your mind the rest of this fourth quarter.
Oh, it definitely is. You can see it by his body language, and you got defenders going over to him, and yeah, there's no doubt. And he's hoping now that the 49ers are trying to get off the field.
No flag. Stafford throws it. Incomplete for Jefferson.
There's nobody that wants this defense to make a stop more than Jaquaski Tartt right now.
Here it is again. Did not have a pick during the regular season. Doesn't have one in the postseason, and they won't be any easier than that. Third down and 10.
Well, here's Kupp in the slot.
There's Kupp. Needs blocks. Got him. First down inside the 30 near the 25.
You go trips to the field, and then you get the ball to Kupp with offensive linemen coming out. You got a convoy, and just put your head down and run. We've seen it so many times from Deebo Samuel. This time the Rams, they replicate it.
End zone. Van Jefferson overthrown by Stafford, and that stops the clock with 8:19 to go. Cooper Kupp, just about every time he suits up, he's breaking records. Now 13th game this season all in with 100-plus receiving yards. Came in tied with Michael Irvin, your longtime teammate, the 1995 season with 12.
Well, and Cooper Kupp hopes his season ends the same way that Michael Irvin's did that year with a Super Bowl trophy.
Both Kupp and Beckham over 100 yards receiving in the game. Play clock at 2-1. just got it away, and the pass to Beckham. Brought down from behind. Kaywan Williams had pressure on that play. And it's another third down call for Sean McVay and Matthew Stafford, third and three.
Yeah, that was pretty tight. Pretty tight. I think the officials were a little lenient on that one, allowing that play to hold. But a big third down right here. And Stafford has to know that he's got three in his pocket and make sure it's clean when he turns it loose.
Cup five catches on third down for conversions. Here's Michelle. Can't break tackles. Brought down by Warner. And Fred Warner's outstanding season continues. It's fourth down and the field goal unit on for Sean McVay, who says, my bad, after that call.
Yeah, he just didn't give Stafford an opportunity to maybe work the field. This is the only place you're going with the football, but Fred Warner, he's the reason why it didn't work. He had played it downhill. He was aggressive. He fought through some blockers.
Here's Matt Gay from 40. Missed from 54 earlier. He's got six. Great game in the AFC, great game in the NFC, with a trip to the Super Bowl hanging in the balance. What a chance a moment ago for Jaquaski Tart. Just could not complete the catch on the interception. Fred Warner over to try and console him and pump him up. Warner made that stop on third down. Force a field goal try by Matt Gay, and here we are. Out to the 25, and we will look ahead, and I'll ask you, with Jimmy Garoppolo about to take the field now. Well, here it is, trip to the Super Bowl, and what every kid dreams about. What do you see the 49ers trying to do here?
Well, first of all, do you think these games are any good this year in the postseason? I mean, pretty incredible, but this is the point in the game where Kyle Shanahan would 100% want to just ride that running game, and we've seen it so many times, but the Rams have done an outstanding job in run defense, and I'm afraid that it's going to have to be Jimmy Garoppolo that gets it done.
Samuel in motion. Good protection. Pass in the ground. Short of Kittle. And eventually Aaron Donald forced that throw. Second and 10.
That's tough duty. Lakin Tomlinson, he's trying to handle him. The speed and the quickness coming off the ball, even going around, even having to go around a big guy like Tomlinson, he's still able to be a factor.
Still no sacks for the Rams. Only one in this game for the 49ers. And now delay of game.
Delay of game. Offense. 5 yard penalty.
So much talk about the crowd and crowd noise and who would have the advantage. The Rams fans making a ton of noise here, and that factored in on the delay of game. Second and 15. To come out to his right. Sideline nearly picked by Ramsey. And he's thinking about what might have been.
You know, on the drop, he had time in the pocket. I'm not sure exactly what took Garoppolo off the left side of the field where he was working. You're going to see it's Ayuk who comes in right over the middle. But Jimmy's working the outside, so he doesn't read that particularly very well. But that's a missed opportunity by one of the best in the game.
But it does make it third and 15. Garoppolo in trouble again. And a drop by Ayuk. Make it Benjamin. And pressure by Greg Gaines as that drive went backward for San Francisco. Fourth down.
Yeah, this is was an abysmal possession by the 49ers. Just got nothing going at all. Even if they make the catch there, there's nowhere to run. They're going to get the ball right back to the Rams.
Deebo Samuel was not out there on that third down play as Wisnowski hits it high and short. Fair catch at the 39 by Brandon Powell. Good field position for the Rams with under 6.5 to go. Justin Herbert, Kyler Murray, and Justin Jefferson are just a few of the NFL All-Stars set to face off in Las Vegas at the 2022 Pro Bowl, presented by Verizon, Sunday, February 6th at 3 p.m. Eastern. Buy your tickets today at ProBowl.com or watch the excitement on ABC, ESPN, and ESPN Deportes. As Ramsey now couldn't get the pick, but helps get a stop and get the ball back. Best starting field position for the Rams, who have gone touchdown and field goal the last two times they've had it. Akers. 3 yard pickup.
Here's the end of that punt, and yeah, just the punishment that Skowronek delivers.
Went helmet to helmet on Trenton Cannon. Second and 7 here for the Rams. Chased by Bosa, and the pass is caught along the sideline by Jefferson. Third down and short coming up.
Nice catch by Van Jefferson. He was banged up coming into this game. He's able to work that sideline, go down and make a catch. Pick up pretty good yardage, make this a third and short. Clock is out.
Well, they've been right up against it a lot.
Yeah, they really have, and I think the officials have been generous.
Stafford fires it, pass caught, first down. And what a night for Kendall Blanton. 8 yards and a big first down for the Rams.
Yeah, you never know when it's going to be your number and your night. And tonight it's been Kendall Blanton's. And like I said, coming off the game against Tampa where he did some good things, caught his first touchdown pass, and man, he's shown up when they have needed him. That was a simple route, but a good route as far as him knowing exactly what he needed to do to uncover himself and catch the ball.
Playing for the injured Tyler Higbee, out with the knee, injured early in the game. Handoff here, and Michelle got hit by Mosley and Warner. A gain of just 1.
And Sean McVay and this Rams offense is doing what Kyle Shanahan was hoping to do, that they can ball control this, get the ball down there, and take more time off the clock. Of course, the 49ers, they still have all three of their timeouts.
Stafford, Beckham. And Beckham is tackled by Emmanuel Mosley, gain of 6.
They've really kind of had that out there as often as they want to take it. You know, you'll see Mosley, he'll be off in coverage, and then at other times he'll be locked up. But there's been a lot of one-on-one looks. I'm actually a little surprised they haven't taken a shot when he has been up in coverage to his side.
Third down and 3.
It's a 55-yarder from here if they don't get anything else.
Stafford throws, pass caught, Kupp still rumbling. Kupp down to the 12.
So outstanding route by Kupp. You see that Mosley, and not terrible coverage. I mean, he's just not able to hang on him. But they brought the blitz. The 49ers do that. They don't do a lot up. The back steps up there and does an outstanding job of taking off the blitz on Stafford to allow him to hang in the pocket and make the throw.
Kupp has converted six third downs into first downs in this game. Hand off to Michelle. Lost one.
Go back to that previous play by Stafford. Right there in the pocket in the middle. Sony Michelle, he picks up Alshire and just enough that allows Stafford to hang in the pocket with confidence and put the ball right on the money on Kupp.
And we are headed for the two-minute warning. Rams knocking on the door. Second and 11. 2 minutes left. The NFC Championship game. Seventeen, 2 minutes left, second and 11 for the Rams.
Well, Kyle Shanahan, he let the clock run down after that play. It was 2:30 left on the clock when the play ended. He let it go all the way to the two-minute warning rather than burning one of his timeouts. A lot of time, 30 seconds to come off the clock.
Stafford is sacked. Second time he's been sacked. Ebukam was first there, and then Nick Bosa and a loss of seven. Timeout, San Francisco.
Well, here comes Ebukam. They put two guys on Nick Bosa. They put him on his back, and he's on the ground as he's making a play. Here comes Ebukam. He's trying to strip it. And then Bosa, you see him on the ground, 97. They knock him down, and it's just, they got Ebukam grabbing one leg, and then here comes Bosa from the ground, and he grabs the other.
Two sacks in the ball game for San Francisco's defense. That moves the ball all the way back to the 20 and makes it third and 18.
Here's Odell Beckham here. You got Emmanuel Mosley across from him. They're running four across zone, four across right here.
Underneath, it's Kupp. Fred Warner closes down. It will be fourth down, and San Francisco uses their second timeout with a minute 49 to go. Rams went all in this year with Super Bowl 56 scheduled for two Sundays from today. They traded six first-round picks since 2018. They're the players they've acquired. Added Sony Michel, Odell Beckham Jr., Vaughn Miller. And their next first round pick, as it stands right now, is 2024, with Super Bowl 56 here in this stadium, and the first time a team has hosted a championship game in the same stadium where the Super Bowl will be played. Bucks won the Super Bowl in their home stadium last year. Here's Gay from 30 yards out. He's got it. Rams are on top. 20-17 with a minute 46 to go.
That's a perfect snap. Good hold. Right down Broadway. I know the Rams were hoping for a little bit more. Sean McVay on the third down and long wasn't going to take any chances. They get the ball out quick, run the screen, and Kyle Shanahan's not even really watching that kick. He knows that he's got to get the ball and do something with it here with Jimmy Garoppolo. And one timeout, plenty of time. Jimmy was in this position week 18 when he needed a touchdown to get down there and tie it up, send it into overtime.
Rams entered this fourth quarter down by 10. And that's their third straight score. A touchdown, then two field goals to take the lead at 20-17. Little note for championship history. Largest deficit entering the fourth quarter, overcome to win 9 points. Seahawks against the Packers. Rams trailed in this fourth quarter 17-7, and now they're up 20-17.
Get into these situations in a game, and the defense is so mindful of trying not to give up the big play that a lot of times working the middle and taking the underneath stuff, you can march yourself right down the field in a hurry.
This ball's batted into the air and drops to the turf as Vaughn Miller had pressure and Gaines made the diving attempt at the pick.
Yeah, an inside move. You see number 40 there. He comes inside on Compton, and he's the one who puts the pressure, and then Gaines gets his hands on it, and Garoppolo was trying to do just that, was trying to come underneath to the running back, to Michael Hasty, who was open.
Second down and 10. Garoppolo's thrown four straight incompletions. Plenty of noise by the home crowd. Garoppolo. Pass caught by Jennings, and he can't make a move to get around Traven Howard. Third down and then long, coming up a loss of three on the play. Garoppolo under pressure. Donald got there in the air, intercepted by the Rams, and they may ride to the Super Bowl on that. Donald with the pressure and Traven Howard with the interception.
They bring five, and you see the pressure. Here comes Aaron Donald. Von Miller's back there, and Jimmy Garoppolo just trying to get rid of the ball and hoping not to take a sack and go backwards any further than he already had. And there's Traven Howard to end the game.
Still no sacks by this Rams defense, but something even better on that third down play. Pressure, the pick, and Matthew Stafford in his first year in Los Angeles. Is going to take his team to the Super Bowl. Kelly Stafford, his wife. Forty-niners now out of timeouts. 1:08 remaining, 2nd and 11. And that may be the lasting image for Jimmy Garoppolo, who likely, not a certainty, but likely will be wearing another uniform next year.
Now, if you're going to end a six-game losing streak to your arch rival, the NFC Championship game's a pretty good one to do it.
Sean McVay, 36 years old, on the cusp of taking his Rams team to the Super Bowl for the second time in his 5 years. One more snap, and the Rams are going to Super Bowl 56. And the Rams overcome a 10-point fourth quarter deficit. Matthew Stafford, 31 of 45 for 337. Two touchdowns and a pick in an emotional moment between Odell Beckham Jr. and